Hey everybody, thanks for tuning in. We just want to take a few minutes and walk through some of our guest service positions that we have. Some of you are going to be new to guest services and helping us at the pavilion, so we just wanted to do this so you have something to be familiar with. You'll notice I'm standing right here at the entrance to the pavilion. This is where people will come in from the parking, okay? And we will have someone here who is the parking lot director who will bring everybody to this point and try to keep them socially distanced in case we have a bunch of people arrive all at one time. All right, from there, they'll go to a person that'll be here. For right now, we're calling them the people flow person. And what they do is they'll stop you, they'll greet you, how many are in your party, and they'll let an usher know how many people we need to seat. The ushers will be behind us here in the pavilion where the seats are. Now, we start at the front, and we start at the far side over there and work back toward the parking lot side and then back so we can keep everybody seated. We're going to socially distance, so we'll put two seats between you and other parties, okay? So if you're not related to somebody, we don't want you sitting with them. We're just trying to follow the state and the CDC guidelines. And that would help us a lot if you would do that. Just come in and sit where the ushers direct you. You're probably going to have some people that are not going to want to sit where you want them to sit, and that's okay. We're not going to make a big deal out of it. Maybe you could ask them if they could wait, if there's a particular spot they want to sit. If they want to be in a certain row, could they just wait here until we fill up to that point? Because it just helps us. We've had such great crowds the last few weeks, and we've had a lot of people move over to overflow that we're going to talk about in a few minutes. And it just works better and smoother if we can get people to go along. If not, let them sit where they want to sit and we'll work around. This is where we will begin to seat people, right here in this corner by the cross. Okay, we'll start here and work our way back toward the parking lot. When the first row is filled, we'll go back to the second row. Remember, we're keeping two chairs between people groups, all right, as we work our way back. All right, some of the other places where we're going to be serving are in the back of the pavilion here, and you'll see these back two or three rows, we have people that like to come in, sort of sneak in and sit back here, as we talked about a little earlier, and that's fine. We just need to be sure that they are socially distancing and we've got the two chairs between people and people groups again. So those of you that are assigned back here, just be aware of that. We will also have someone assigned at the back corner right here by the ladies restroom to direct people around the pavilion when we get ready to go to the overflow, which you can see over my shoulder. Okay, if we get full, that's where we're going to go. When we fill up inside the pavilion, we're going to send people around to come over to the overflow. Now those of you that are doing chairs, when you seat your people and you have the two spots, we're going to pull the chairs out and go ahead and carry them over and set them up in overflow, okay, so that we're not trying to do that during the service time. It's already ready from when people come. The person who's back here directing people and those of you who are assigned to the overflow need to stay there working for probably about 10 minutes after the service starts, okay, because people, you know, we don't always get here on time. Things happen. We have little children, and we all know how that was, trying to get our kids ready to church and on to church at times. Sometimes we even have trouble with that. So we need to allow for late people. So stay in your spot if you're assigned back here to the back to overflow guidance and then overflow seating for about 10 minutes after service time starts. And again, remember, those of you doing the chairs, go ahead and start early. As soon as we fill up the first couple of rows, start getting the chairs out and then move them to overflow. And also at the end of the service, if you're doing chairs, you're going to help put them back so that they can be ready for the next service that's coming after us. Okay, just a few more things for us to remember. When it's your Sunday to serve, we need you to be here 25 minutes before the service starts. We're going to meet in the back of the pavilion by the ladies' restroom. We'll talk about any announcements, go over any last-minute changes. Maybe somebody wasn't able to come. We've shifted some assignments, those kinds of things. We'll have a word of prayer, and then we'll go to work. Now, also, when you get directions from us, a text from me or an email from me or Wes, we're talking about right and left sides of the pavilion. So how we've oriented that is from the back looking forward, the right side is the parking lot, and the left side is overflow. So that's how we're going to reference things. Right for the parking lot, left for overflow, okay? If there's a medical emergency, you need to look for either me or Miller Birdsong. And we're watching, we're looking to see if something's going on, but look for us and we'll come and help you, okay? All right, the last thing I'd like for you to remember is one of the points that Wes has talked with us about as guest services, and that is everything we do speaks, okay? So when we're here working, that speaks not only to our Lord, but our care for the people that are here worshiping with us. And so we need to be really aware of that, particularly when it's song time, okay? If we're not working, we're not seating people, then we need to be singing and participating in the worship. We need to really lead by example and make it a really good worshipful experience for everybody that's here. Again, thanks for all you do. Thanks for being faithful and coming every Sunday and working out here. Nobody's complained about the heat. Nobody said a word. Y'all just served. Thank you very much, and we love y'all.